Welcome to Study the Bible with me. Today we are starting from where we stopped last time, so grab your Bible and let's dig right in. 1 Kings chapter 12. And Rehoboam went to Shechem, for all Israel were come to Shechem to make him king. And it came to pass, when Jeroboam the son of Nebat, who was yet in Egypt, heard of it, for he was fled from the presence of King Solomon, and Jeroboam dwelt in Egypt, that they sent and called him. And Jeroboam and all the congregation of Israel came, and spoke unto Rehoboam, saying, Your father made our yoke grievous. Now therefore you make the grievous service of your father, and his heavy yoke which he put upon us lighter, and we will serve you. And he said unto them, Depart ye for 3 days, then come again to me. And the people departed. And King Rehoboam consulted with the old men, who stood before Solomon his father while he yet lived, and said, How do you advise that I may answer these people? And they spoke unto him, saying, If you will be a servant unto these people this day, and will serve them, and answer them, and speak good words to them, then they will be your servants forever. But he forsook the counsel of the old men which they had given him, and consulted with the young men who were grown up with him, and which stood before him. And he said unto them, What counsel give you, that we may answer these people who have spoken to me, saying, Make the yoke which your father did put upon us lighter? And the young men who were grown up with him spoke unto him, saying, Thus shall you speak unto these people who spoke unto you, saying, Your father made our yoke heavy, but you made it lighter unto us. Thus shall you say unto them, My little finger shall be thicker than my father's loins. And now, whereas my father did lead you with a heavy yoke, I will add to your yoke. My father has chastised you with whips, but I will chastise you with scorpions. So Jeroboam and all the people came to Rehoboam the third day, as the king had appointed, saying, Come to me again the third day. And the king answered the people roughly, and forsook the old men's counsel that they gave him, and spoke to them after the counsel of the young men, saying, My father made your yoke heavy, and I will add to your yoke. My father also chastised you with whips, and I will chastise you with scorpions. Wherefore, the king hearkened not unto the people, for the cause was from the Lord, that he might perform his saying, which the Lord spoke by Ahijah the Shilonite unto Jeroboam the son of Nebat. So when all Israel saw that the king hearkened not unto them, the people answered the king, saying, What portion have we in David? Neither have we inheritance in the son of Jesse. To your tents, O Israel, now see to your own house, David. So Israel departed unto their tents. But as for the children of Israel which dwelt in the cities of Judah, Rehoboam reigned over them. Then King Rehoboam sent Adoram, who was over the tribute, and all Israel stoned him with stones that he died. Therefore King Rehoboam made speed to get him up to his chariot to flee to Jerusalem. So Israel rebelled against the house of David unto this day. And it came to pass, when all Israel heard that Jeroboam was come again, that they sent and called him unto the congregation, and made him king over all Israel. There was none who followed the house of David, but the tribe of Judah only. And when Rehoboam was come to Jerusalem, he assembled all the house of Judah with the tribe of Benjamin, 180,000 chosen men, which were warriors to fight against the house of Israel, to bring the kingdom again to Rehoboam the son of Solomon. But the word of God came unto Shemaiah, the man of God, saying, Speak unto Rehoboam the son of Solomon, king of Judah, and unto all the house of Judah and Benjamin, and to the remnant of the people, saying, Thus saith the Lord, You shall not go up nor fight against your brethren the children of Israel. Return every man to his house, for this thing is from me. They hearkened therefore to the word of the Lord, and returned to depart according to the word of the Lord. Then Jeroboam built Shechem in Mount Ephraim, and dwelt therein, and went out from thence, and built Penuel. And Jeroboam said in his heart, Now shall the kingdom return to the house of David. If these people go up to do sacrifice in the house of the Lord at Jerusalem, then shall the heart of these people turn again unto their Lord, and even unto Rehoboam king of Judah, and they shall kill me and go again to Rehoboam king of Judah. Whereupon the king took counsel and made two calves of gold and said unto them, It is too much for you to go up to Jerusalem. Behold your gods, O Israel, which brought you out of the land of Egypt. And he set the one in Bethel and the other he put in Dan. And this thing became a sin, for the people went to worship before the one, even unto Dan. And he made an house of high places and made priests of the lowest of the people, which were not of the sons of Levi. And Jeroboam ordained a feast in the eighth month, on the 15th day of the month, like unto the feast that is in Judah. And he offered upon the altar. So did he in Bethlehem, sacrificing unto the calves that he had made. And he blessed in Bethel the priests of the high places which he had made. So he offered upon the altar which he had made in Bethel the 15th day of the 18th month, even in the month which he had devised of his own heart, and ordained a feast unto the children of Israel, and he offered upon the altar and burnt incense. Chapter 13. And behold, there came a man of God out of Judah by the word of the Lord unto Bethel. And Jeroboam stood by the altar to burn incense. And he cried out the altar in the word of the Lord, and said, O altar, altar, thus saith the Lord, Behold, a child shall be born unto the house of David, Josiah by name, and upon you shall he offer the priests of the high places who burnt incense upon you, and men's bones shall be burnt upon you. And he gave a sign the same day, saying, This is the sign which the Lord has spoken. Behold, the altar shall be rent, and the ashes that are upon it shall be poured out. And it came to pass, when King Jeroboam heard the saying of the man of God, which had cried against the altar in Bethel, that he put forth his hand from the altar, saying, Lay hold on him. And his hand which he put forth against him dried up, so that he could not put it again to him. The altar also was rent, and the ashes poured out from the altar, according to the sign which the man of God had given by the word of the Lord. And the king answered and said unto the man of God, Entreat now the face of the Lord your God, and pray for me, and my hand may be restored me again. And the man of God besought the Lord, and the king's hand was restored him again, and became as it was before. And the king said unto the man of God, Come home with me, and refresh yourself, and I'll give you a reward. And the man of God said unto the king, If you will give me half your house, I will not go in with you, neither will I eat bread nor drink water in this place. For so was it charged me by the word of the Lord, saying, Eat no bread, nor drink water, nor turn again by the same way that you came. So he went another way, and returned not by the way that he came to Bethel. Now there dwelt an old prophet in Bethel, and his sons came and told him all that the works the man of God had done that day in Bethel, the words which he had spoken unto the king. Them they told also to their father, and their father said unto them, What way went he? For his sons had seen the way that the man of God went, which came from Judah. And he said unto his sons, Saddle me the ass. So they saddled him the ass, and he rode thereon, and went after the man of God, and found him sitting under an oak. And he said unto him, Are you the man of God who came from Judah? And he said, I am. Then he said unto him, Come home with me and eat bread. And he said, I may not return with you, nor go in with you, neither will I eat bread nor drink water with you in this place. For it was said to me by the word of the Lord, You shall eat no bread nor drink water there, nor turn again to go by the way that you came. He said unto him, I am a prophet also, as you are. And an angel spoke unto me by the word of the Lord, saying, Bring him back with you into your house, that he may eat bread and drink water. But he lied unto him. So he went back with him, and did eat bread in his house, and drank water. And it came to pass, as they sat at the table, that the word of the Lord came unto the prophet who brought him back. And he cried unto the man of God who came from Judah, saying, Thus saith the Lord, For as much as you have disobeyed the mouth of the Lord, and have not kept the commandment which the Lord your God commanded you, but came back and have eaten bread and drunk water in the place of which the Lord did say to you, Eat no bread and drink no water, your carcass shall not come unto the sepulchre of your fathers. And it came to pass, after he had eaten bread, and after he had drunk, that he saddled for him the ass, to wit for the prophet whom he had brought back. And when he was gone, a lion met him by the way and killed him. And his carcass was cast in the way, and the ass stood by it, and the lion also stood by the carcass. And behold, men passed by and saw the carcass cast in the way, and the lion standing by the carcass, and they came and told it in the city where the old prophet dwelt. And when the prophet who brought him back from the way heard thereof, he said, It is the man of God who was disobedient unto the word of the Lord. Therefore the Lord has delivered him unto the lion, which has torn him and killed him, according to the word of the Lord, which he spoke unto him. And he spoke to his son, saying, Saddle me the ass. And they saddled him. And he went and found his carcass cast in the way, and the ass and the lion standing by the carcass. The lion had not eaten the carcass, nor torn the ass. And the prophet took up the carcass of the man of God, and laid it upon the ass, and brought it back. And the old prophet came to the city to mourn to bury him, and he laid his carcass in his own grave. And they mourned over him, saying, Alas, my brother! And it came to pass, after he had buried him, that he spoke to his son, saying, When I am dead, then bury me in the sepulchre wherein the man of God is buried. Lay my bones beside his bones. For the saying which he cried by the word of the Lord against the altar in Bethel, and against all the house of the high places which are in the cities of Samaria, shall surely come to pass. After this thing Jeroboam returned not from his evil way, but made again of the lowest of the people priests of the high places, whosoever would he consecrated him, and he became one of the priests of the high places. And this thing became sin unto the house of Jeroboam, even to cut it off, and to destroy it from off the face of the earth. We're going to be stopping here today. Next time we shall be starting from 1 Kings chapter 14.